This is a prayer to break the Freemason generational curse, which is a very, very powerful curse. It's powerful because it's based upon Luciferianism or worship of Satan. And the only thing that will break it is a prayer created specifically for Freemasonry and using the power of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I've used this in the past. I knew a woman who whose grandfather was a 33-degree Freemason, and it was very effective. I was able to pull three demon spirits out of the woman just using this prayer. At the time of his death, her grandfather handed her his Quran, and I didn't understand why a Scottish Freemason would have a Quran, but I came to realize that once a Freemason reaches the 30th level, they switch from using the Bible to make their oaths and their vows to using the Quran. They become disciples of the demon Allah. And so Freemasonry is such a powerful force in the world right now that world leaders are using Freemasonry. Hollywood actors are seeped in Freemasonry. It has lots of writings and teachings that go all the way back to ancient Babylon. And these people have secret symbols, they have secret signs, they have secret handshakes. And the reason everything is secret is this goes back to the time when the Tower of Babel was broken by God, and he distorted the language of people all over the world. And one of the things that came out of this was the secret languages. They felt that this would never happen to them again, and so therefore they devised a secret set of handshakes and eye signals and all kinds of things that would remain with them in case God decided to change language again. I know that sounds crazy, but that's what it is. So you can see here Freemasons come in all varieties and shapes. They're all over the world. They're in Russia. They're in music. They're in Hollywood. A Hollywood artist will sell his soul to Satan and take in a demon, which will then propel him to stardom, and he will just sit in the back seat and watch this demon run his life, and he will do that to become rich and famous. It's Luciferian, especially around the 1700s when the Illuminati was created. As you can see here is Albert. General Albert Pike, the leader and founder of Freemasonry in the United States. The Masonic religion should be, by all of us initiates of the highest degree, maintained in the purity of the Luciferian doctrine. If Lucifer were not God, would Adonai, or Jesus, spread false and harmful statements about him? Yes, Lucifer is God. And this is the guy that founded the KKK. This is the guy that founded Mormonism. These guys are very, very powerful, and this goes all the way back to ancient Babylon and to ancient Egypt, and they're all tied together. When the Pharisees left Israel at the time the temple was destroyed, many of them took their flocks back to Babylon, and in ancient Babylon, they worshipped the tree of life, what they called the tree of life, which is in fact the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And that's how you can tell the difference between the Bible and Luciferian religions, because they switched the two trees. So they developed something called the Kabbalah, and they took what they call the tree of life, but which is actually the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, and they created blood covenants with these demonic spirits, especially the spirit of this serpent. And that serpent spirit, which you can see intertwined in that tree right there, is what in India is known as Kundalini. In Kundalini, they have a tree of life. They call the tree a chakra system. And that chakra system is how people deploying yoga and mystical arts will raise that serpent spirit up through the spinal column and into your brain. And it will go into your pineal gland, where it will take charge and take control. You become a backseat driver in your own body, and Lucifer or Satan takes full control. There's a demon spirit, a serpent spirit, that commands you and guides you and makes you rich and famous like a Hollywood star. And so there are a lot of people that are involved in this all over the world, and they pretty much run the world. These are the tares. You've heard about the tares in the wheat. Well, these people are the tares, and they are very powerful, and you can always tell them because they love money and wealth and power. Love of money is the root of all evil. That's Paul said that in the Bible. So you can always find them because they're usually the richest people in the world. So here's a picture of a blue guy. He looks like a Nephilim or a fallen angel, and he's mated with a human woman, just like is described in Genesis 6. And these Nephilim took over the world, and they are here today in other forms. So now let's get into the prayer itself. That was a little bit of background, real quick glimpse, but the prayer itself is very long and very powerful. And if you read along with me, and we read in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you will be set free from even the Freemason curses. And these are curses passed down by people in Freemasonry to their families. They actually make vows on their families' lives. Heavenly Father, you alone are perfect righteousness and the only creator and source of truth. Forgive me my sins, Lord. I repent and turn to you for my salvation. Through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, and the blessing of your Holy Spirit. Right now I declare that I break every agreement with Satan and the works of darkness. I choose this day to divorce the enemy, to renounce or repent of any covenants that have been made by myself or other family members in my generational line, according to your word in 2 Chronicles 7:14. Father, you said that if I would humble myself, pray, and seek your face, if I would turn and repent from my wicked ways, you said that you would forgive my sins and heal my land. Whether I or other family members have partaken of these sins knowingly or unknowingly, I ask your forgiveness and I renounce the following: all spirits of fear, the fear of man that brings a snare, self-pity, insecurity, and inferiority. I renounce and forgive those in my family line for the need to control or manipulate others out of a sense of fear, insecurity, or inferiority. Forgive us for not trusting in your provision or your timing and for failing to rest in your love. I renounce all spirits of heaviness that bring depression, mental illness, obsessive compulsive disorders, schizophrenia, suicide, and grief. I renounce the spirits of unbelief, double-mindedness, the cares of this world, and all things that would give me the divided loyalties in my heart and mind towards God. I renounce every seed that Satan has sown into my heart and mind that would cause divided loyalties and weaken my convictions toward Jesus Christ. Those came from the pit of hell. Jesus died for this truth, and I will not reject your truth. I reject the lies from the enemy and declare that I receive the truth and the healing that is afforded to me as a child of God. For it is written, by his stripes I am healed. In Jesus' name. I renounce and forsake all spirits of discontent, complaining, a vagabond spirit, wandering, and irresponsibility that have come from iniquity and from idolatry. I renounce and forsake any sins and demonic spirits associated with gambling, poverty spirits, laziness, and sins of poor stewardship. I renounce all addictive behaviors given in excess, greed, or stinginess. I renounce bitterness, jealousy, strife, anger, hatred, profanity, gossip, lying, slander, and murder. I renounce the bitterness that comes from being hurt or mistreated or injustice that has occurred towards myself or others in my family. I renounce the spirit of Cain, which is a murderous spirit. I repent and forsake the sins of slander, hatred, and evil speaking. I renounce the bitterness that comes from being hurt or mistreated, injustice towards myself or others in my family. I repent of my judgments against others. Forgive me and those in my family for any sins of hard-heartedness, being critical or condemning, or showing lack of compassion towards others in their time of need. Forgive me and those in my family line for turning a blind eye towards those in need and withholding good when it was our power to help. I renounce and forsake unforgiveness, including unforgiveness toward myself, retaliation, and vengeance. Forgive me, Lord, for any time that I or my family members have sown seeds of discord or caused pain to others through our actions. Forgive us our acts of maliciousness or things that I or the family members have done with the intent to hurt and cause pain to others. Forgive me and those in my family line for selective obedience or ignoring the prompting of your Holy Spirit when you wanted us to show love, mercy, grace, or compassion. I renounce and forsake the sin of pride, lawlessness, rebellion, selfish ambition, presumption, and testing God. I renounce and forsake atheism, mockery, scoffing the things of God and your Holy Spirit, grieving the Holy Spirit, and unbelief. Forgive me, Lord, for allowing spirits of inferiority or insecurity to drive me to feel as though I have to prove myself to others, myself, or to you. Forgive me for believing these lying spirits when they tried to form a false image in me. Your word says I am fearfully and wonderfully made, and I am made in your image. I am accepted just as I am. Forgive me and my family line for despising godly wisdom and authority or rejecting your counsel. Forgive us for self-rule and choosing authority figures that do not represent your government or authority for our lives. I repent from any time that I have cursed God or others. Forgive me, Lord, for loving gossip, slander, and my judgments more than I loved your law of showing love and kindness. Forgive me for not blessing others more freely, even those I do not like, or those that have been an enemy. I renounce and forsake all soul ties to illegitimate spiritual fathers or spiritual leaders, religious attitudes and spirits of legalism, disrespect, self-righteousness, prejudice, controlling behaviors, manipulation, imposing my will on others, racism, disobedience, independence, critical spirits, arrogance, vain, and judgmental attitudes. I forgive everyone that has knowingly or unknowingly contributed to my hurt. I renounce and forsake spirits of rejection and abandonment, all lying spirits, and command them to leave me at once. I repent for sins of judgment or rejecting others, withholding love, acceptance, or forgiveness. I renounce and forsake spirits of self-hatred, self-rejection, unloving spirits, guilt, unforgiveness, and anger toward myself and to others. I renounce the lie that sins done to me by others were my fault. I renounce the shame and condemnation that have come as a result of deep wounds, embarrassment, and sins that were done to me from others. I surrender my pain and anger, and I want no benefit from it anymore. I surrender the memories of hurtful events in my life. Take it, Lord, offer it all to you right now. Help me not to take it back. I forgive those individuals, Lord. I put them in your hands. Forgive me for not being able to separate the sin of those that have hurt me from them as human beings that have also been hurt and used by the enemy to hurt others. Forgive me for the times when I have not honored nor shown respect to those in authority, parents, spouses, or others. Forgive me for not humbling myself or apologizing when I should have done so. Forgive me for broken relationships, broken vows and covenants, and please help me to do whatever I am responsible for to make things right. I ask you to heal the breach in relationship between myself, others, and you. I renounce and forsake all worldly addictions, including drugs, alcohol, nicotine, gambling, gluttony, compulsive physical exercise, compulsive spending, sexual sins against myself and others, pornography, and sins of excess that feed the lusts of the flesh. I renounce and forsake the spirits of lust, bondage, pharmacia, or drugs. I renounce and forsake the spirit of pride and Leviathan. I renounce and forsake the perverse spirit and all that is connected to it. I renounce and forsake incubus and succubus spirits, spirits of voyeurism, homosexuality, bestiality, and anything connected to demonic sex. I renounce and forsake unfruitful thoughts, fantasies, all unclean and seducing spirits, and the deceiving spirits connected to the perverse spirit. I renounce ungodly soul ties, those of former lovers, false authority figures, and soul ties to anyone that would keep me from moving out of my past and into the good future that you have for me. Let those ties to the past be severed now, in Jesus' name. I repent all sexual sins. I renounce and forsake the strong man of Baal and divorce all ungodly spirits of lust, sex, and witchcraft. Please heal the fragmentation in my soul and in my spirit. I renounce and forsake all false gods and masters and all evil inheritances in my generational line. I renounce and repent on behalf of myself and my ancestors for any covenants or agreements made with the familiar spirits or angels, knowing they are in fact merely demon spirits. I declare there is no other God except for Jesus Christ, and I break any connections or agreements that have been made through candle burning, calling on the names of false gods or saints, and invoking their assistance. I renounce all lies and false teaching that blinds me to the truth and that mocks and resists God. I renounce all ungodly symbols that connect me to false teaching, false gods, ungodly alliances, and pagan symbolism. I accept and receive no inheritance from evil sources, only that which my Heavenly Father permits and allows. Let all evil inheritances be broken off of me and my family. I put them under the blood of Jesus. I renounce and forsake the spirit of mammon, greed, and selfishness. I renounce and forsake the divided loyalties that come with a love for money, covetousness, idolatry, and envy. I renounce bitterness and the lie that I am not blessed by the Lord. I renounce the lie that I will be happier with more material possessions. I renounce the lie that somehow I am rejected or unworthy because I do not have more possessions. I renounce the sin of comparing myself with others. I renounce and repent for any involvement with secret societies and the ungodly covenants they demand. I renounce and forsake all pledges, oaths, and involvements with Freemasonry, lodges, societies, or crafts by my ancestors and myself. I renounce all false marriage covenants and mock ceremonies of secret societies. I renounce and forsake blasphemy and taking the Lord's name in vain, as well as blasphemous oaths and pledges to Satan by any other name and alliance. I renounce and forsake all witchcraft spirits. I renounce and forsake all practices and traditions of Santeria and Lucemi and praying to false gods, saints, or Orishas. I renounce and forsake the Rosary Cross, the Rosicrucians, and all ungodly alliances, oaths, and associations to grand knights. I renounce and forsake all false gods of Egypt, as well as the lust of power, prestige, and position. I renounce and forsake all secret signs and handshakes. I renounce and forsake all false gods, false doctrines, unholy communions, and abominations. I renounce and forsake the Luciferian doctrine. I renounce and forsake the oaths spoken to pledge loyalties to man or idol that violated the commands of God and conscience. I renounce all false masters associated with Freemasons, Shriners, Mormonism, Paganism, the Ku Klux Klan, and other lodges and secret societies. I renounce and I forsake the false god Allah. I renounce and forsake all words and phrases used as secret codes, and I break agreement with all curses that were once agreed to be placed upon any and all family members, including myself and future generations. I renounce and forsake the compass point, the cable toe, the hoodwink, the ball and chain, the apron, the noose around the neck, the sword, the spear, the blindfold, and the mind-bending effects of those things. I renounce and forsake all penalties associated with breaking these ungodly oaths and covenants. I renounce and forsake all play-acting and rituals depicting murder and death and the spirit of fear associated with death as a curse. I revoke and break the power of agreement with these ungodly servants of darkness, satanic worship, and all associations with those in fellowship of demonic alliances. I command the curse to be canceled and all ungodly covenants and agreements broken and nullified both in the earthly and the spiritual realm, in the name of Jesus Christ. I ask you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, to heal and to restore every area of the physical body and ailments that have been suffered as a result of the curse brought on by any involvement by anyone in my family line. Forgive us, I pray, for committing sin, iniquity, and blasphemous acts against the Holy God, ourselves, and others. I renounce, forsake, and divorce myself from, and break any on all agreements, covenants, or involvements with all line spirits, the occult, demonic spirits, Native American and cultural rituals and traditions involving the use of idols, witchcraft, voodoo, the practice of hoodoo, root workers, witch doctors, conjuring, the practice of juju, black magic, white magic, Wicca, and the use of mediums, familiar spirits, and seducing spirits. I renounce and forsake all oaths and rituals to false gods, witchcraft covens, sorcerers, Satanists, or workers of iniquity. I renounce and forsake any and all sins involving the abuse of trust, authority, power, or using our influence in an ungodly manner. I renounce and forsake sins involving magic, sorcery, practicing charms or incantations, the use of horoscopes, tarot cards, fortune telling, astral projection, psychic energy, or astrology. I will burn and destroy all books, spells, incantations, rings, and other objects that connect me to ungodly occult practices, lodges, secret societies, or their unholy rituals and their practices. In the name and authority of Jesus Christ, I also bind all loas, mediums, and familiar spirits, ungodly priests, priestesses, sorcerers, and wizards that are synchronized with Catholic saints, the seven African spirits known as Papa, Legba, Aptala, Oya, Oshun, Chango, Ogun, and Yamaya, and other names by which they are known. I bind any and all inanimate objects from being used in any sort of witchcraft, voodoo, hoodoo, or other form of demonic practices, and loose all evil spirits off individuals, objects, and evil altars. I command them to go to the abyss that was created for them in Jesus' name. I renounce and forsake all spirits of divination, the spirit of Python, Pythos, the serpentine spirit, and all that take the form of demonic serpents. I renounce and ask your forgiveness, Father, for speaking things in your name, even prophesying, that has been out of the flesh rather than the unction of the Holy Spirit. I renounce and repent for all broken covenants, unfulfilled vows and promises, betrayals and divorce. I ask you to please disentangle me and release me from ungodly covenants, vows, and peace treaties, and all unrighteous agreements that would bring me into relationships where I am unequally yoked with things of the kingdom of darkness, evil, and wrong relationships. Lord, let there be a release of every curse that has come against me or my generational line as a result of these things. I decree a cancellation of every form of witchcraft and curse that has resulted from my involvement or that of my generational line. I ask you, Lord Jesus, to come and deliver me and my family from all demonic spirits that have come as a result of a curse. I ask that you deliver me and my family from every affliction, illness, disease, allergy, or physical condition that has affected us. I ask that you restore all the years that the enemy has stolen. Let finances, health, and relationships be restored. Let peace, joy, mental health, and emotional stability be restored. Let the blessings that have been held back, stolen, and hidden by the enemy be released into my hands now. In Jesus' name, let all demonic attachments be severed from me and my family line, both in heavenly places as well as on earthly realms. I declare that every seed that was sown by Satan in order to perpetrate a curse or cause myself or someone else in my family line to reject my Heavenly Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, must now shrivel and die immediately. Jesus, I give you permission to change what you know needs to change in my life, and to convict me if I resist your Holy Spirit. Your word says in Isaiah 54 that no weapon formed against me shall prosper, and every tongue which rises up against me in judgment shall be condemned, and that this is my inheritance in the Lord. Right now I condemn every negative word that has ever been spoken over myself, my family, and my future, in Jesus' name. I repent for and I condemn every negative word that I have spoken over myself, my family, and our future. I repent for negative words that I have spoken over others, and I declare that I will not boomerang back into my own life or theirs. I break the power of those negative words that hang in the spirit like a curse. I declare that those negative words will no longer ring in my ears, nor in those that have heard or repeated negative condemning words. I declare that words that have been used as a weapon will no longer ring in their ears for my loved ones and hinder their faith or their future in Jesus' name. From this day forward, I declare their ears shall be deaf to condemning words, and only faith shall prosper in their heart, mind, and spirit. In Jesus' name. Father, I repent for those sins on behalf of me and my family to the 10th generation back. I thank you for your forgiveness and cleansing of these sins. I declare that when I am tested, the Spirit of God will arise within me and bring me to a place of victory. I give you permission in advance of any situation I may encounter, that you and your Holy Spirit may change my actions, words, and responses so that I honor you. Please reign and rule over my emotions. Enemy, according to the scriptures in James 4:7, as I am now submitted to God, you must flee from me. I command you to take everything that you have put on me, everything that you have tormented me with, every sickness, and go. I command you to pay restitution at no less than sevenfold return, according to Proverbs 6:31, in every place that you have brought poverty, defeat, robbery, or death, and destruction. Father God, I ask that you cleanse my mind of all unfruitful thoughts, fantasies, and works of the flesh. I thank you for the blood that Jesus Christ has shed on my behalf, and I appropriate the power of his blood and the resurrection power of your Holy Spirit to every sin, transgression, and generational iniquity over myself and my family line. By the power and authority of the blood of Jesus Christ, I declare my victory. Satan, you no longer have authority to torment me or my children with iniquitous sin patterns. Your plan is cut off now in Jesus' name. God has promised in Hebrews 8:12 that he will be merciful to our unrighteousness and our sins and lawless deeds. He will remember no more. I loose myself and my family from demonic attachments, that I have been invoked for safety, protection, healing, provision, prophecy, and for financial blessing. I declare the names of God over every name in heaven, in the earth, and under the earth. I declare the name El Shaddai over me and my family, for he is the God that is mighty, and he is our sustainer. Yahweh is exalted as the sovereign God, our creator. I declare Jehovah, in Hebrew Yahweh, over me and my family, for he is the one that causes victory over our enemies, and he is the Lord of hosts of angelic armies and our household. For he is the one that heals, and he is the one that provides. I release the spirit of adoption over myself and my family members to draw others into personal relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ and to shed abroad the revelation of Abba Father in the hearts of every individual. In Jesus' name. Jesus, you are the Son of God, and you are seated victoriously at the right hand of the Father. Today I declare that the enemy is defeated where I am concerned. You are my Master, my Lord, and my Savior. Please come with your Holy Spirit and heal my mind, my emotions, my thoughts, my confession, and my memories. I forgive those who failed to reach out to me when I was hurting. I forgive those that have unintentionally caused hurt and pain to me and my family, and those that have done it unintentionally. I ask you to bless, heal, and deliver those that have acted in ways that have hurt me or caused harm to me and my family. I will trust your judgment and that you will judge fairly and mete out any justice in these issues. Bless those that have hurt me, lied about me, or deliberately caused harm to me or my family, and set me free from offenses. I release them to you now. Please forgive me, Father, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit for willingly disregarding your words and your spirit when you have tried to get through to me. Please heal my trust issues with you and with others. Please heal the issues related to my past, my present, and my future. Heal my hope, my faith, and my love. Heal any areas of grief, heaviness, unbelief, and let the renewed mind of Christ be strengthened and formed in me each and every day. Thank you for releasing me a spirit of faith, a spirit of obedience, a spirit of adoption, and the spirit of revelation and truth. Help me to hear and to listen to your Holy Spirit, my counselor, who I freely open to at this time to be my guide in all things. Thank you for eternal life, health, and victory, and for restoring my life and my future in Jesus' precious name. Amen. God has set you free in the name of his only begotten Son, Jesus of Nazareth. Jesus really loves you.